morning from the beautiful village of Sati. We are going for a stroll before we're heading out for our next part of the day. We're going to go and explore this beautiful village and yeah, just see what we can find. We got up for sunrise, can you believe that? Guy we're staying with, and he's a blacksmith. He makes horseshoes. Mm. Yeah. He made this all by himself.
Yes, he made it by himself right there.
And what makes it a winter horseshoe?
Because it has this one, so horse can stop. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Oh, so this helps make it hot.
Yes.
Oh wow.
The air goes there, and it's hot is warm.
And then it heats the furnace.
Yes, heats faster.
Then melts the metal and then bends it into shape on the anvil here. You going for a ride, Dad? Yeah.
Hello.
Trying to find some food.
Hello.
See you later, Dad. Meet you back in Almaty. We have porridge for breakfast made with soy milk.
And rice.
Yeah, it was
soy
milk.
And rice. It's rice pudding.
No,
it's oats.
It was avsyanka.
Oats?
Avsyanka, sir.
Mm. Oats.
Yes, oats.
Yeah,
oats. Yes, porridge.
Nice.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. What I've loved about staying in a local's house rather than one of the big fancy hotels is that I know that the money that we're paying to stay here goes directly to them and their family, helps them with their lives and everything they're doing. And yeah, it's just been a really amazing experience, really unique as well, just seeing this very rural village that's living very basically, and it's just been super refreshing as well. Like, we haven't even had phone service out here, there's no internet. It's been a really beautiful couple of days. And yeah, we're heading back to Almaty now. It's a 4-hour drive. Let's do this. Before we leave, gonna get some fresh water from the well. Is that good?
Oh, that's so fresh. Oh, perfect.
We needed some petrol to get back to Almaty, and the only gas station in the town seemed to be closed, no one was around. Plus, I think a lot of these villages only really use diesel because obviously there's a lot of farming vehicles and stuff. Anyway, we were waiting around for like 5 minutes. Eventually, he rang someone or spotted someone on the other side of the road, and they came over and unlocked the gas station, which is fun. If we hadn't been able to get petrol here, I think we would have got stranded. have stopped off at the Black Canyon on our drive through. Oh my gosh, this is crazy. Ada just told us that the Black Canyon becomes Charing Canyon, where we stayed in the yurts the other night. And this is the Charing River that's running through the canyon here. Saying goodbye to our driver, Sahir. Thank you so much for driving us. It's been a great adventure. We are now heading to a ski resort called Shambaluk, which isn't in season now, like no one's skiing because it's summertime. But I think it's pretty amazing views from the top, so we're gonna jump on this ski lift. We're in the gondola. What's the difference between a gondola and a vernacular?
I don't think there's a vernacular.
So we've just taken the second ski lift.
Yes,
combi two. Yeah, we're just taking number one and two, and now we're heading on to the third cable car. I'm just going to call it a cable car because you can call them different things, but the cable cars. Third cable car up to the very top now, and I'm already feeling a temperature drop. It's feeling cool. I've got my coat here just in case. Ada's been looking after our tickets because we're not responsible enough to look after them ourselves. This way. So are we at the top now?
Yeah.
We've reached the top. 3,200 meters. Check this out. 3,200 meters. That's pretty high. That's almost 10. That's 10,000 feet, isn't it? We are so close to the snow line.
Check it. Wow.
We are meeting with Step Spirit, who have been taking us on this tour, and the Kazakh tourism board, and they've just given this coat to my dad.
According to our traditions, we should wear it for you. It is a present from heart of Eurasia, from Kazakh Norman Isle. So the name of this gift is Chapan.
That is good.
Yes, it's our traditional hat.
So now you are.
Yeah. Yes, Dad.
Perfect fit.
Yes.
That is great.
I should wear this at home.
Okay.
Thank you very much. It's been an honor being here.
Unfortunately, we have to leave now. We have to leave Ada.
So she's
been amazing. And Yeah, thank you to Step Spirit and Kazakh Tourism as well for all the support. We will be back. We will be back. Dad, he's got his Kazakh hat on, traditional Kazakh hat in the aeroplane.
I am the only one. Don't know why. This Kazakh seems to be wearing a national dress.
Well, guys, my Kazakhstan trip is over. I'm in the plane on the way home, doing the classic vlogging in the toilet. But yeah, this trip was the trip of a lifetime. Honestly, Kazakhstan has been this country I've known nothing about, yet has always intrigued me, and it truly lived up to everything great I've heard about it. And it was just a magical week. It was a pleasure to speak at that conference I've been invited to speak at, but also just exploring the country, getting the chance to tick another country off the list, but also just, I don't know, just experience something completely new again, because that's something you miss if you're going to a lot of similar countries, a lot of developed countries. But there's something really beautiful about Kazakhstan as it's flourishing. It's had a really tough past from the Soviet era, and just loads of stuff that's happened in Kazakhstan, but I really feel like they are about to flourish in many ways, and I think tourism is going to really kick off there. So it was really cool to see the beginning of what hopefully will become a booming tourism industry there. And I can't even begin to talk about what my favourite parts were, but I think just having the opportunity to go with my dad was really special to me, because we don't get to travel a lot together anymore. Obviously, I'm really busy living in America, and he's got a pretty busy year teaching, but thankfully this fell on his summer holidays, so he was able to join, and it was all last minute, but it was really good father-son bonding time. And I really feel that I'm lucky to have such an amazing dad. So if you're watching, Dad, thanks a lot for just everything you've done for me. And hopefully we get to do some more adventures soon. And I would highly encourage you guys, if you haven't spent a lot of time with your parents, or you have opportunity to travel with them and do things, just take that opportunity, because life is short and life gets busy. And I think it's something powerful about bonding as a family. And just go out there and explore the world. If you haven't had a chance to do much traveling, I would highly recommend it. I really feel like it shapes you, broadens your mind, and it gives you a lot of, empathy for other people around the world, and understanding and intrigue, and just really helps you celebrate and connect with other people's cultures as well. So I will catch you next video. Peace out, enjoy life, and live the adventure. Boo.